कृषी विपणन आणि रोगासंबंधित माहितीपूर्ण व्हिडिओ बघण्यासाठी कॉटन गुरु यूट्यूब चॅनल सबस्क्राईब करा आणि नवीन व्हिडिओ बघण्यासाठी बेल आयकॉनवर क्लिक करा.
नेक्स्ट स्पीकर इज फ्रॉम बांगलादेश, मेहदी अली जी, मोस्ट वेलकम मेहदी.
थँक्यू मनीष भाई, थँक्यू व्हेरी मच. Yes.
Ex-President Bangladesh Cotton Association. He's in close relation with the consuming industry in Bangladesh, and he's very experienced, very influential in Bangladesh. But at the same time, he's rooted to the ground, and he has very good relations with the government also. I would like to hear your views. Any opening statement, Mehdi ji, and then the question.
Okay. First of all, good evening to all gentlemen here. And many thanks to Manish Bhai for organizing such a beautiful event and in obviously inviting me here. And many thanks to the United Nations for declaring October 7th as a World Cotton Day. And I thank you to my friend Kai Hughes and his entire team of the International Cotton Advisory Committee for highlighting the importance of the cotton to the United Nations. Keeping in the mind shift to the organic products in everything we use in daily life, from food to cloth, due to impact of chemicals being used in everything mankind producing these days, there is high demand of organic cotton globally. Consumer, especially the new generation consumers are very concerned about the environmental footprint of the products they consume. This includes sustainable products and production methods, materials, etc. To respond to this demand, large fashion chains around the world are committing themselves to using more organic or recycled cotton fibers in their products. The increasing demand for organic cotton is helping helping improve soil sustainability, water conservation, air quality, and the livelihoods of farmers. It is also contributing to the fight against climate changes. That's why conscious brands are getting more interested on certified cotton. The demand for organic cotton increasing, and growers are convinced to grow it to get premium over regular cotton. If I'm not wrong, now Pakistan also started its own organic production. So we can understand the organic cotton demand. Organic clothing is becoming more popular in the USA and Europe because of the health benefits of eco-fashion. Another reason is increased awareness of the importance of fair labor condition. Demand on the other side, however, is very high, as more more brands are committing to a more sustainable sourcing than BCI and cotton made in Africa or similar. I expect prices to trade range bound until March, and then increase once running Indian organic has been consumed. In this season, supply for organic is rather tricky, I would say, mainly because of two developments. Number one is organic fake contract in, or I will say fraud in the in India, and repercussions in the industry. And number two is a ban of Xinjiang cotton and other products from that area. Bangladesh mills are importing organic cotton mostly from India. Bangladesh bought Indian organic cotton with huge premium, about 75% premium in some cases. It has increased their yarn, fabrics, and RMG cost. Ultimately, their RMG units are losing organic business as brands, retailers, and finding less costly organic cotton, organic RMG from Turkey and other sources. So considering the situation of the last year, I am guessing Bangladesh will not all keen to buy much Indian organic cotton. I am expecting this year local control union body will be strict, so better to take all documents, including TC plus that full traceability documents, and re-verify with the issued office in India before making payment to supplier. So Manish bhai, thanks everyone for listening to me so patiently. I am concluding my speech by wishing everyone good health. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Thank you, Vaidhi ji, and wish you a very, very happy new season.